in that changing room to try and inspire my men to show some physicality at the breakdown and see if they can't muscle their way back into this game. From Italy's perspective, I think purely same again, isn't it? You don't have to think about how to beat these guys. You know how to beat these guys. And I think if they continue as they did in the first half, they'll put this to bed reasonably quickly. The big question mark is, you know, are Argentina going to come out of that changing room with some fire?
They said of last week that they had a will to win Italy. 10-3 down at half-time. Well, laid that criticism and his team before last week. And a lax spirit. Certainly they have worked on a hunger for victory before this sort of series started. Gori has pitched it. Ghirardini, Limona, Parise. Montero with a tackle, but Parise, such wonderful soft hands. Popped it up off the floor. Gori again, Massi. Great experience there. The playoff was involved in play. Fullback just glided up. Says I'll be first receiver. Parise again.
Use it!
Gori is told to use it by the referee. Gori says it will go left. Knocked on. Miguel Denhaus.
A little bit scrappy, but certainly signs at the breakdown that Argentina are competing a little bit harder. A couple of great opportunities. On a turnover, you can see there. Pretty basic error, wasn't it, from the Italians there? But, you know, when they did turn that ball over, you saw the tempo from Italy rise again, the physicality. They drove them back 10 metres and turned the ball back over again. And you talk about that will to win and that spirit that seems to exist in the Italian side.
Bind, set.
Test match here in Genoa. First since losing to Argentina back in 2005. And Pierre
Barbizier.
And look at that. The effort that is going into that scrum. A real honest scrummaging, isn't it?
You may have picked that as a wonderful moment. One of the referees, Mike Craig Joubert, saying, oh my goodness. At that scrum, that was quite incredible. I'd love to see my host broadcaster a replay of that, as you say. Hugely honest scrummaging from both teams.
Do you know, they just stuck in there, didn't they? I am not going back one inch, and you could see it. Every muscle dragging every last bit of energy, and it did not move an inch. And the hooker didn't even hook for the ball for fear of that being the thing that broke the camel's back, as it were.
Just didn't want to move, did you even breathe in there?
And as just the turf slid back, it was extraordinary.
11 blue.
Can't be the greatest open running game of rugby if we're getting that excited about a scrum.
Do you know what? I don't care. I love that.
Fuente. Oh, high tackle from Bernardo. Moroni goes down. Sato is chasing. And Samuel Isino. Got it down over that white line just before half-time, didn't he?
Yeah.
Simon Joubert wants to check with Simon McDowell.
Just going to have a look at whether it was taken back in goal.
Not a question of whether it was a try or not, just a question of what to give next. 22 or a scrum 5. Smart from the Italians as well, though. Saw the space back there, didn't he? Booted it down well, and he just didn't quite have the pace. Oh, scrum 5 it is. So, another opportunity for Italy.
A chance you to get excited about a scrum.
Yeah.
Unashamedly so.
I'm with you. Absolutely with you. Right beside you,
Pat. Blue scrum, no.
As we are in this commentary box.
You wouldn't want to be the groundsman, though, would you?
No, the levels of rain is quite incredible out here. storms expected to hit tomorrow, which is the reason for bringing this game forward. We need to hear worth the damage has been done.
Find. Set.
Region of North Italy. Good. Giovanni just goes down. It's Gori who's caught. Hernandez. What's a neat step from Hernandez. Mattesi. Been around the clubs, hasn't he? England and in France. Matias Cortesi. Northampton, Biarritz, Bayonne, Gloucester. Not yet. Luca Sarto. Isn't he suspended from this Italian squad? Luca Sarto. Brompton's contrary to the principles of discipline and respect after the actions after victory over Brive. European competition no for Zebre. Liotta. Real arm wrestling this. Opening 6 minutes in the second half, isn't it?
It is, but this isn't the place to be playing rugby. Boot on the ball, otherwise you're going to give Italy an opportunity.
Wait, what?
Hernandez gave the pass out to the outside backs there, falling over that cut-up turf from where that scrum was. You can still see it on the left-hand side of the picture.
It's like a meteor crater.
Forner. Lavanini smashes into the right, but it's still Parise with possession.
Turnover is good, arriving
player. Argentina timing. They're rucking much better in the second half so far. But somehow Gori gets the ball back. Aimona with a left peg this time. Magusha doesn't have too much side of the bath, man.
White, keep going.
Nice. So off to the centre for Italy, and Woss as well, but he's played plenty of games for Woss in the last season or so at fullback. Nice of Elliot Daly and Chris Bell in the centres. McLean, Morisi, Gori again, McLean, Sarto. Somehow finds a way through the heavy traffic. Gori again. Parise at pace this time. As his old chum, Castro Giovanni, in attendance. Giraldini. Crowd beginning to get themselves involved as Argentina turn the ball
22.
Over. We were playing advantage. And it's Italy's penalty.
Yeah, great play from Italy again. How much more rugby does Barnsley want to see?
22.
Well, Paimona, before he says he's the real deal, to me he's having an absolutely brilliant game at the moment. Instrumental to everything. And you've got to say his decision making, when to kick, when to run. Been absolutely perfect. I'd put my reputation on the line and say I think he's going to be in that Italian 10 shirt for a long time to come.
You heard it here first. 10 caps, I think, is the answer to your question.
I really hope he doesn't miss this kick.
Well, the Italian players have been playing groundsman.
Step it down. Yeah.
So Doro share the ground. Football team. They won't like that, will they? Ballers. It's big heavyweight rugby players scrummaging on their field. Aimona gets the kick. And Katsanas can breathe again.
It's still all Italy, isn't it, at the moment? And they're starting as well, I think, just to get some. Still, it's still only a one-score game.
see a little bit more from it in this second 40, aren't we?
We are. They look like they can run to the ball. Well, it's all through Haimona, though. He's having an absolutely brilliant game. He's running at the right time, kicking at the right time, and you compare that to what we're seeing from Hernandez at 10, where they're playing deep in their own half and they're making errors in their own half because of it. And right now you wouldn't have thought, one guy just burst onto the scene, the other one had been on the international scene for years.
Montero is offended and stayed down as well. McLean and Morisi.
I called it over and I think it was a reasonable chance.
Mixed up slightly. That it. Took a move from Santiago Fina, didn't it? Slight controversy.
22 sub.
He's put some freshness to that coaching box. Freshness to the players involved. The Argentinian squad. Assisted by Pablo Duzo, of course.
You just wonder, don't you, that how much did the rugby championship actually take out of Argentina? They have to compete incredibly hard week in, week out throughout that tournament, and perhaps at the moment we're seeing a knock-on of that. The subs are warming up, and no great surprise, and they've got a big job to do, but can make a huge impact if they come on, really add some energy into the environment.
The rugby championship earlier this year, we remembered for one thing, for Argentina there.
Yes, sir.
First ever win in the tournament, 21-17.
Crouch! Bind!
Yolanda!
Sit!
Mendoza. Such a battle that the scrum. Again, the turf is.
I can see the pitch.
Rolling
up. Doing this. Come towards me.
Referee has concerns. It's seen it already that players are tripping up over it. I mean, it's a great, pure spectacle of this scrum.
What I love about it, though, is that very, very rarely do you see props happy to hang in there. And just push. One goes down, they twist, they turn, it's a reset. Not these guys, too proud. Won't take a backward step. And that in itself, I think, is a great spectacle.
I think it's forged these scrums between that battle against those old teammates, Castro Giovanni and Ayerza.
I think that's exactly what it is. Those two set the tone.
Natori, that one was rather rolled in. The second row streak by Cubelli, Hernandez. There's high, Massi comes for it. Castro Giovanni playing like a footballer for a moment. Somehow, Argentina have the ball. Pino Fuente.
Just a moment of madness, wasn't it, from Castro Giovanni? I don't think his teammates can quite believe what he did.
Belly snuffles it up. Moroni.
It's the sort of thing you do in the training ground, isn't it? Yeah, it comes forward. I'll just take a boot on this one. I'm annoyed. Next thing you know, he's put a lovely little kick. Exactly. A lovely little kick for Argentina to run onto. And he must have hit it and thought, oh, what have I done?
Okay, I'm coming.
It's just one of those instinctive things, but
time on.
I'm laughing about it.
Yep.
Again, it's.
Is it move, Jacko?
Italy. You didn't have a score clock and you'd be watching this game. You think Italy were 10, 15, even 20 points ahead of this game. The control that they've had on the ball, on the game itself. They keep gifting opportunities to Argentina, and Argentina are too good a side. They're not playing well, absolutely. But they're too good a side to let those chances go begging. We saw that right at the end of the first half.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And I think nobody would be more relieved to see that clearance kick going to touch 40 metres out from his own line than Castro Giovanni right now. I mean, could you imagine if that actually cost them a try? I mean, you'd never get over it.
Got a few miles on the clock, and you've got a few. Performances in the back, backwards, forwards, he's gory. A lively scrum half, isn't he? Former under 20s captain. Real leader within this squad as another man. He's back from injury last week. There was a handful of them. Gory, what do you see? Zani as well.
Thanks.
He's out. Argentina's sight for the referee. Otero, such a big man. 14 tries in his 18 tests before tonight. That is some strike rate.
Better from Argentina then. You just sense the Italians starting to slow down a little in defence. Not quite getting back on the back foot quick enough. They weren't getting around the corner with quite the same zip as the first half. And it purely just looks like a fitness thing. You know, they're not quite as fresh. And you can see this slowly but surely. This game is just starting to open up. And at 15-10, you're right. You know, the Italians are putting enough in to win this game. But it's by no means won. And there's a big chunk of this game to play out now. And I think it looks like it's about to loosen up. It's anybody's game. It really is.
They've won the last seven of the eight games. The two sides have played each other. They won the last six in Italy, Argentina. Almost thought we had a big W in the Argentina column. Since 2008, when Nick Mallett was in charge.
That's gone backwards from White. Blue, carry on.
Parise, audacious, audacious skill from Sergio Parise. Incredible skill. Blown away by that.
Me too. But as a coach, I'd have been screaming, please someone kick it off. Please someone kick it off. And yet, absolutely extraordinary. Absolutely extraordinary. Goes back there, ref quite right. Parise gets the ball. Out of a crack. Fantastic chip. Beautiful offload. At this point, it was all on, wasn't it? But to have, it's not so much the confidence to do it. It's almost the audacity. In a game at 15-10, to say, do you know what? I'll just have a little chip here out of my own 22.
The weight of the chip. Just on his toes and his boot.
It's the sort of thing that has to come off, otherwise your teammates looking and think, are you mad?
Professor Giovanni had his mad moment, didn't he? Like, potentially that was for Sergio Parise then. Dario Cristallini comes on. Started last week in the absence of Professor Giovanni. Guaro comes off as well.
Crouch.
Fresh legs.
Bind. Stand up, please.
I mean, it came off, no, so you give, yeah, so you stand back and applaud a brilliant piece of skill. I still question whether it's the right thing to do.
They put brakes on the bind.
The new hooker, not pre-engaged, ear to ear.
Well, it did come off, and it was wonderful skill.
Ear to ear.
We've spoken about it for a couple of minutes, and that will live long in the memory.
Crouch!
Just jealous.
Point!
That's the bottom line here.
Set!
Slightly, I mean, it was brilliant, but you know, to me, this is a test match. It's high pressure, and you play the percentages. And if you do, when you have the most, you know, the obvious advantages that they have right now, you win the game.
Oh, he's chipped it right through! Della Puente! What a moment! Just like in the first 40 minutes, Argentina. Hardly any control of the game at all. And then Hernandez shows what beautiful soft hands he does possess. De La Fuente, a brilliant hard line, and he was straight through, hardly a finger laid on him, and it is all square with the conversion to come.
Well, Fernandez at the line, drew his man well, but the momentum was created from the quick tap and go. And that's it, isn't it? It's his test match rugby. One mistake, that's all it takes, and the margins are so fine. And he has looked dangerous when he's attacked the line tonight, Hernandez. Hasn't always made the right decision, but one thing is, he's a threat with ball in hand.
Somehow, Argentina have the lead.
To be honest, the somehow comes from Italy not playing the percentages. You know, when they have come up, when they've come off, you know, what is a fairly well orchestrated plan, they've leaked points. And I think that you know, when they've tried to overplay, the first half, the hack through came from them overplaying. The second half led to a scrum, 35 out from overplaying. And they just don't need to. When this game is structured, they are the better side. Over.
Looking to get back to that structure then. Italy. Gori. There's Grimaldini. See the physicality of the man there. House. He'll take the pass. Teresa Stare. He's mastered that over the years as well, isn't he? There's his son of many years, Alessandro Zani. 85 caps he has as well. Key man, he's missed 7 months. Alessandro Zani.
I'm not talking again.
Ruptured eardrum, had a clear out of the knee while he was at it as well, but he's back in the fold for Italy. This build up to the World Cup continues. Teresa wins the line up. There he is, Zani. Sanitore.
Right away, what?
In the end, gets his man down. Jordan Hicks. Limona. Morissi. It's caught, isn't it?
Backward.
Okay. Strong challenges from Argentina. That looked forward, and it was.
Forward pass.
There's a bit of bounce about Argentina now, isn't there? You can see they're hunting for those tackles, they're hitting the rucks harder. Much, much better, and it's amazing, isn't it? A moment like that, that 7-pointer, and it's just injected them with some energy. And, well, 20 minutes to go, 2 points in it. And it's incredibly evenly balanced at the moment. And ultimately, it's going to come down to the impact that the subs can make, you feel.
New half-backs as well. Martin Gandajo. Thomas Cubelli. Nicolas Sanchez on as well. For Juan Martin Hernandez.
Okay. And that's a massive, massive decision from Argentina.
Thomas still off.
Those half-backs, whether you think they played well or not, you've no idea what's coming next. At least you knew that they came back into the game the last 5 or 10 minutes. You're the two most influential guys on the field. They touched the ball more than any other position. You've rotated them, and well, we'll see now, won't we, what sort of effect these two can have on the game.
Roberto Di Marchi on that front row for Italy as well. The sail map last week.
Tackle assist 20.
The number 9 is playing in all 18 of the Rugby Championship games. Captain against Ireland in the summer.
There's been a sequence of penalties now from Italy, haven't there? And it's pretty basic stuff there. Second man into the tackle. On the man whilst he's still in the air. Didn't release. Attacked the ball. And just too easy for Joubert to give those penalties, and the momentum right now is with Argentina.
Gracias, Valdez. 21-year-old hooker. He played in the 2-year World Championships last summer. Argentina Jaguars captain under coach Daniel Falcao. He's bringing those youth players through, isn't he? Needs to freshen up the squad. 2-point game this time. It's Argentina who have the lead. De La Puente is rather pushed off the ball by Campanaro. Massi. Di Marchi again. He's in there to help out. Campanaro. Another young man. Straight for the under 20 setup. For 3 years in a row. Such a talented man at such a young age. He plays with Teresa. Here's Massi. Heavy challenge in the midfield. Teresa is still down, isn't he? Continuing player down as well. Giordini brings it to this near side.
Let it go, 22!
This is Gomindo. New flanker. Teresa is up. The referee in the end has to stop playing.
I don't want to put them in danger.
Rightly so.
Hold the ball, Medics are in the way. I don't want to put them in danger.
That was an interesting little chip there from Argentina. If you look at both sides defensively, loads of people in the defensive line. Very little out the back. Argentina there, multi-phase defence with only the fullback behind. And that little chip three on both sides appears now to be on. Loads of space in behind the defensive line. And I think that was made very obvious, actually, to some extent from Argentina's last try. It was a clean break through the midfield. Yep. There's nobody out the back. And you can see here, it's a lovely straight defensive line from Argentina. Acres of space in behind.
Herrera, wasn't it, with the tackle. Ortega Desio. He's back on his feet. He's got a try against Scotland, didn't he? Galloped 60 metres. That Montero hit on Greg Laidlaw.
Crouch. Bind. Pre-engage
from Argentina for the first time in this game. Minutes gone in this game. 17 points to 15.
Hasn't been an issue. Unbind, ear to ear, not engage.
Will Argentina?
If it happens again, penalty.
Look at 7 Crouch. In a row here in Italy.
Bind!
In the backyard of the Azzurra. After a morale boosting victory after in Samoa last week, Italy will feel with a Springbok coming next week to Padova. They achieved hardly anything in Victoria over Samoa if the scoreline stays the same. It's so important that they back that victory up today. Some foundations before South Africa came. Yes. Valdez.
6 blue.
Six
blue. Never onside. Was he part of the back line, Jacko? Yeah.
Zani is offside.
6 advancing. Offside.
Let off for Argentina.
Yeah, and it's two or three penalties on the bounce now. So hard, isn't it, to get any momentum. When every time you get down there, you're getting marched straight back again because you can't keep your discipline. Yeah. And that's really what's letting Italy down right now.
The longest kick from Argentina. Golofinka, the try scorer in the second half. Vinny is hungry for that ball and for that reason won it. Sanchez makes the push Italy back into that corner, yeah, back into their 22, and that's what he's done.
Yeah, it's the second time that I look, the big advantage, I guess, from sitting and watching the game for 60 minutes, is you get to see how it unfolds, you get to see where the weaknesses are in those defensive systems, and we talked about the robustness of that defensive line for Italy, but twice now Sanchez has found that space in behind, and in all fairness, looks like a smart move, because he's able to keep that pressure on Italy at the moment.
Guido Petti on his debut. It's a sad end for him. Looks like a nasty knee injury. Yeah, he does.
Time check, please, Simon.
Lucas Ponce, reliably informed.
Yeah, thanks.
It is pronounced Ponce.
Time.
Going for the Curtin University of Buenos Aires. Sad end for a man from the San Isidro club. Petty, on his debut, looking some discomfort as well, some pain. But it's Italy trying to play their way out of their 22.
Holding on, put the ball down. Arriving player White, holding on.
Yeah.
17 arriving player.
Argentina have a penalty.
So all that hard work really has unraveled for Italy, and again, you just question, don't you? You know, they win the line out cleanly. You know, Parise could just take it up, could just go to ground, could go back to the 10, they could stick it out for but they don't. They play around, you know, Parise takes it up, he shows an inside pass, then they come around the corner, they play again. And to me, I don't understand the need for that extra phase of rugby.
Sanchez was never going to miss from there, was he? Debut for Toulon a couple of weekends ago. Scored 16 points against Grenoble. A 61-28 point thrashing. Marco Bortolami. More experience than the Centurion off the bench. Italy 39 times, second only to Sergio Parise, but Argentina. Don't get a third set piece right, don't get the restart right, but it's Ifri showing really good strength. A 21-year-old. Was it Toulon for a while? Only had one appearance against Biarritz before going back to the Santiago Lawn Tennis Club. Sanchez. Top four from Navarro. And Rossino slips in at first to see who it's. Fregen. Second cap tonight.
Thanks.
Navarro waits.
Use it! No.
Well. There's enough playing around here. Italy back. It's McLean. There's this one bouncing.
Backward.
Fumatore, a little juggle from him. The referee said it went backwards. And the end, Argentina has just slightly won the kicking battle, but it'll be a throw for Italy to the line out. And they're 5 points down and under 10 minutes to resurrect this situation.
Yeah, and right now I rather fancy Argentina. I think they seem to have their head on. Sanchez in particular knows how to close a game out, and he's looking rather ominous with the, and when you consider all the good work that they've put into this game, they've got 10 minutes to get some momentum back into it.
Zua, Portolami on. Manuel Cuera. Another one drawn in Argentina.
No, and that's a great decision from Italy there. Money ball at the front, get the drive going, get some control back in the game. Good decision.
Zani, that's going to half as well for the team. New halfbacks there for both teams. Campanaro! Been so quiet all game. Suddenly he bursts into life. As he can. Here come Italy. Parise! Passes behind McLean with the winger. And overrun it slightly. Now Italy need to show some composure here. Parise. Bortolami. And those two players, there's plenty of experience on the field to see this situation out. Aquera knows the penalty is coming.
Well, that pass from Parise. A 3-on-1 that has to be converted into a 5-pointer. Fantastic work from Campanaro. You know, 3 points just isn't what they deserve from that passage of play, is it?
We get three here. Make it a 2-point game. Plenty of time on the clock.
And to be fair, I don't think it's Parise's fault. I think he's meant that just as a simple pass.
Time check, Simon.
To his inside centre for him to tip it onto the winger. Yeah, and I think he's thought it's a missed pass. Seven. And, you know, actually, probably not Parise. I think the blame falls squarely on Parise there.
Aquera does make it a 2-point game.
You've got him. Seven. OK, we're good.
Minici comes up. Andrea Minici. 16.
Drop time. Move away.
Zani. Cuera. Score high. Under pressure again.
It wasn't a particularly well-worked exit play again, was it? Two or three phases and then back to your number 10 under pressure with an on-rushing defence. At that point, you really
let's go,
you just want your number 9 to take the pressure off you and stick a box kick up, really. Little things like that, which they were executing well in the first half, have just crept into the game.
Crowd get themselves involved after that rumble. And Ichi Campanaro again, the danger man. Look at that hair. He seems to be moving particularly quickly, but he really does. And across the ground so quickly. The outside centre. And a Zani. Minici, run from him, entered as well, didn't it? Gildenhuis, good hands. Ifa, he's in there again. Ifa made the hit, took his hands away, went in, turned the ball over, and that may well be the moment in this game. Great work from the blind side flanker.
I might have some bias towards that, but an effort like that to get your head over the ball, take a hit for your team, you know, as important as a break, it's as important as a pass that breaks the line. Moments like that can win you games.
And then Luciano Aquera replies with a Hal Witzer of a kick. sends Italy all the way back to Argentina's 22.
Yeah, 4 minutes remaining. Italy still look reasonably composed at the moment.
Forget. Again, it's complicated from the line out. And the reason for that, trying to set this angle up for Nicolas Sanchez. And in the end, it does work out for Argentina. Sartor can do nothing about it. And Italy will have to go from here. We're going to see it again, aren't we? This turnover work from IFA.
Three men, couldn't get him off, and he goes back in for more. And it was, it really was a cracking piece of back row play.
Paul Griffin, the expert for the host broadcaster. Oh, scrum half of it, choosing the man of the match, but
push back here.
Again, the IFA has to be close. Zani is there, one last twist in this game. His ebbs and flow. Second half time, Italy should have the game dead and buried. But Argentina, either side of half time. Amorosino just before the break. De La Fuente just after the break. With tries for Argentina. And it's Sarto.
Lost.
He loses the ball in the challenge.
Lost forward ball.
Backwards from him, referee
contact,
says.
Please, Simon.
Scrum down to Italy.
Well, there can only be one, possibly two more opportunities for Italy, but again, it's a midfield scrum. If there's a set piece that's good to attack from, it's a midfield scrum. Parisi in the base as well. Yep. First things first, the front row have got to do their job. And they've got to set this up and give them good, clean ball if they can. And it's one last hurrah from Italy.
We wondered whether Italy were going to have the character
Crouch.
To win this game over Point. Again in the second half. But it is Argentina who showed the character. Some great substitutions along the way.
A real pressure here on the tight head for Italy.
What is that?
Castellini was going up. It's Parise who comes out. 1 minute. Just over 1 minute left in this absorbing test match. Zani smashed back.
All it needs
Use it.
Is a penalty or a drop goal, a bang in front of the sticks. He's in the pocket.
Aquera waits directly behind here. Argentina know it's coming. Aquera. Why?
Can't check, Simon.
That was the moment. 30 seconds left. Referee just checks the time.
30 seconds.
Argentina will not rush here.
Can't kick it directly.
Enormously ambitious, though, isn't it? 40, 45 metres out. You're either a hero or a villain. They might just get one more crack from this 22.
Sanchez goes long. Quera. Massi trying to chip ahead.
Backward off blue, off white.
Argentina have it and they will kick it out and they will win the test match. They've won two in the last three now. And that